lineup of the Standing Policy Committee on Water, Noise, Riverbank Management, and the Environment. October 31st, I'm joined by Councilor Gervasi, Councilor Edie. I'm Brian Mays. I'm the chair of the meeting. In honor of Councilor Fielding, the Cubs fan, I think, Mr. Security Guard, we should throw at the gentleman in the Atlanta Braves hat right away. Perhaps Councilor Fielding would be proud of us. He's having a good year so far, but his team's two wins away. So I think we have, Madam Clerk, minutes to approve from the last meeting. So moved by Councilor Gervasi. All those in favor?
Aye.
That's carried. And one delegation only, and that is Councilor Allard, to be heard in support of the item number
three.
Thank you.
Ready to go.
You're not showing us a video, are you?
I said you're not showing us a video.
No, and also for your information, I've spared the committee and the public wearing of my Superman's father costume, which I was sporting over the weekend. So
saw it on Facebook.
Wasn't sure if it'd be appropriate for a protocol or not. So. Apparently, it was okay. So I'm speaking in favor of the report on the Lindale Drive retaining wall. I just want to urge the committee, and I know there's a positive report there, to please approve the report. The work is necessary as this is a primary dike. Any delay will increase costs. Not only is the work necessary for flood protection, but also necessary to protect the core infrastructure necessary for people to have their water and sewer serviced in their homes. So on that front, please support it. Also, the public service has done a tremendous job in terms of public engagement. I personally attended two public open houses on the preliminary design, two public open houses that were there to support the preliminary design. My office also promoted these open houses, and feel that the work done there was professional, and that the 109-page report is comprehensive in terms of the feedback that was received by the public. And I believe the design option that came out of those discussions is a good balance of all of the feedback that has been received. I also want to talk about this report in terms of what it means for the Promenade St. Boniface River Walk. So as part of this work, there's also going to be upgraded active transportation facilities along the stretch. And in terms of a larger vision for the St. Boniface River Walk, this Lindale Drive could eventually stretch, and we could have a linear parkway go all the way from Lindale Drive. It would follow the riverbank to the bridge, and then to, the Norwood Bridge, and then to the St. Boniface Hospital. It would go all along the Promenade Attaché Riverwalk, and would eventually connect all the way to Whittier Park, also known as Voyageur Park. So obviously that's going to take many, many years to complete, but this is one of the pieces of the puzzle to the Promenade St. Boniface River Trail. I will be thrilled to see this go through if it does get council support. And for those reasons, I urge you to please support this report.
Thank you. Councilor Edie.
Yeah, two questions. One is the AT trail not Lindale Drive?
There are existing facilities. This would be an upgrade and a reconfiguration.
So like Scotia, Lindale Drive is actually the active transportation trail?
And there's active transportation facilities there, though they're incomplete. There's just a stretch of trail which ends, unfortunately. But I don't know if I'm answering your question.
It's not a clear question, a clear answer, but isn't the street itself the AT trail?
There are, the street does close for bike-only traffic along weekends.
Right.
But there's also other active transportation facilities on the street.
Between the street and the river.
Right.
Is it?
Okay. The other question is, how far is this work happening from the Winnipeg Rowing Club?
From Winnipeg Rowing Club?
Yeah.
There's no AT trail coming through their lot.
No.
So the AT trail comes up onto Lindale at that point?
It It starts on Lindale and stops on Lindale.
This is more the bit that's off the Churchill High School as opposed to the bit that would be by the rowing club.
So it's much further south.
Yeah, yeah, the directions get tricky because it's a curve.
It's part of the path.
Well, no, anyway, yeah. Counselor, I'm just trying to figure out how an AT path's going through the Winnipeg Rowing Club lot.
That's all. Oh, yeah.
if the AT trail isn't Lindale Drive, right?
Right.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah, there are three different Lindale projects. One got done, this is the second, and there's a third potential one. So yeah, this can get a bit, there's a Claremont one. This can get a bit confusing as to which is which we're dealing with. Yeah.
Okay.
This is a good one.
No, they're all
the next one comes up, we'll hold
the 18 trails good too, but I was just trying to figure this out in my head. Where
this is one of them.
That's
okay.
You gotta watch yourself, there's lawyers in the room, right? That's right.
I
Good. Thank you, Councillor. Okay. Any other questions? Sorry. No?
Nope,
okay.
Thanks.
Thank you, Matt.
Sounds good.
Okay. No other delegations, no, Madam Clerk? Okay. So we are, and yeah, just for reference that when we come to the Lindale item, it's page 2-31 of the 2016 capital budget. So that's where the funding's coming from. Okay. So then on to, I think, Mr. Patton, our familiar friend from the water utility is here to deal with a couple of items, but in item number one is an extension of time request, I believe, on the motion from April 2016 in regard to garbage recycling and organic waste.
That's correct, yes. The department, I understand, we're requesting an additional 30 days to respond back to the motion. Work's ongoing. But it'll take a little bit longer to complete.
Councilor Gervasio.
Yeah, I'm wondering if there's been any discussion with the Waste Minimization Advisory Committee in sort of, as we're getting to this point, I realize it's just a report sort of outlining what you want to do going forward with consultation, but have they been included in the process at all?
Councillor, I can't speak specifics, but I'm assuming that they would be. We've been very active with the committee, but I'm not aware of any specific meetings. But
would you be able to take that back and check?
Yes.
Because I've heard from a few people who want to make sure that they are. So
yes.
If you maybe could just take that back and see, there might still be time to have a conversation with them, if that's appropriate.
Yes, I'll do
Thank
that
you.
And report back to the committee.
Yep.
And just so we can confirm, I know last week we passed a motion at council that talked about talking with CUPE in regard to a number of initiatives, including the compost pilot project, if we do that. So if we can keep CUPE in the loop as we move forward on this, I guess the report's coming next week. And I know Ms. Garrett said to me this morning that she would be in contact with CUPE this week about starting those talks on the bulky waste. But just while we're thinking of organics,
okay.
So that'll be underway this week on the bulky waste, but on the organics, if we can just make a note to make sure we that motion, it will be, it's a change in direction, as Councillor Gervasi has pointed out, since 2005, so it's going to be part of our discussions as we move forward.
Yes.
Okay, any further questions?
I'll move extension on the support for 30 days.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Contrary, that's carried. You're here on number two as well?
That's correct. Yes.
Okay.
Yep.
This, any questions for admin from councillors? This is the adopt the drain motion. Anything you wish to say, Jeff?
Well, just in terms of, just as a summary, as we've done, we've gone out and done significant research with a number of municipalities across North America. We found that these programs vary very widely. There's ultimately there's very low participation rates, but we're actually estimating costs for staff and advertising of additional $45,000 per year that are not currently part of our operating budget. But basically that the public service, the department's recommending that we don't move forward with an adopted a drain program, as specifically it really only targets a single resident. There's much broader scale education that we would prefer, that we actually do, and we would like to enhance many of those efforts that we currently do through our work with Fort White Alive and with our information on our website in terms of the catch basins. There's a lot of bylaws that govern the catch basins, and right now, as we've mentioned here, we've been supporting the Yellowfish Road program through Trout Unlimited Canada and our and Fort White Alive, and we're also looking to the city is considering a 2017 grant from Trout Unlimited Canada to support the Yellowfish Road. So Yellowfish Road, groups of volunteers go out and paint small yellow fish and provide information to residents about you know, the catch basins in their neighborhood and what's appropriate to send down the catch basins and not. So this has been a volunteer program, and it's been very good. My understanding, it's been piloted for the last few years, but they're kind of widening out their cast of information throughout the city. So that's really the summary of the program.
Thank you. Any questions?
So you're saying you hope to perhaps enhance it a little bit in terms of what we're doing now without this program, but just with enhancing the existing?
Yeah, we can leverage existing resources right now and enhance some information on our website to kind of bring more education to people in terms of what's appropriate to send down catch basins. You know, people might also, in terms of encourage them to remove any debris, leaves, et cetera, that might be clogging the catch basins to improve their the street drainage. I believe that's already been dealt with through other committees in terms of a targeted fall cleanup program that will be ongoing. But in terms of so I don't know if that, so we're going to utilize existing resources. We're focusing on what's appropriate to go down the drain in our kind of education.
Yeah, it was just a suggestion that, perhaps we could have something go out with the bill, in the fall for people. Might be an idea, as well as we've been doing those enhanced communications for councillors to notify their constituents with social media and other tools. Both of those would be. Pardon? I find those helpful.
I'm not going to tell my residents to clean the leaves out of the catch basins.
Well, I'm going to. No, I mean, I don't mind having
You're
those.
You're going to say, what do I pay taxes for, Councillor?
But some of mine like getting that kind of information. Sure. I guess there's Councillor Edie's may not.
Yep.
But anyway, if those tools could be provided, that would be great.
I'll take that back. Certainly, we are constantly sending out information through the utility bills to customers, so we're looking at this as well.
Yep, great. Okay, well, I would move the receipt of this information.
I just wanted to get clarification. You're requesting $45,000 more dollars for 2017?
No, we're not. We're not recommending the program go forward. We're just the motion.
It's an ask. We'll have a motion then to receive the information. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. I guess we need motions from Councillor Gervais. Okay. Thank you, Mr. Patton. We move on then to the big ticket item of the day, at least in financial terms, the Lindale Drive retaining wall rehabilitation. I think we have staff here. Michelle Staten is here. I don't know if you want to speak to this, but perhaps fire away and then we'll see if there are any questions.
I don't know there's much to say. It's simply a report to secure funding to award or award a contract so that the work can take place over the winter on the budget that doesn't occur until.
So it's a first call, it's already budgeted, you're saying?
Yeah.
It's forecast.
Yeah.
You're going to want to get started over the winter.
To delay it would cause further deterioration of the river.
Absolutely.
Let's get it done.
I admire the enthusiasm, and I will be wanting just a couple of questions to clarify.
It'd be nice to have $100 million.
The 2016 capital budget had allocated $5 million in 2017 for this project. That's on page 2-31. So we're drawing down, that's what we're advancing, that's what we're making the first call on. So we're not over budget,
No, this is just to, we can't award a contract having council approved. And it's not council approved yet, it's only forecast.
So. And as I learned at the Gay Park the stabilization, this work takes place usually in January, February due to the river level. So we're, if we didn't do a first call now, we'd be slipping a whole year, right? So to get this done in 17, we got to go now. Okay.
Sounds good. Get it done. Come on,
Chairperson. Last point, this is in addition. I'm, you know, we've had some coverage recently about city needing to put more into riverbank stabilization, and this is big. This is 2.7 was the component of this with riverbank stabilization, and this is public work. This is in addition to the PP&D million or million and six that they normally put into riverbank stabilization. Right?
I believe so.
Yes. Okay.
I'm getting nods from.
Yeah, I don't think it's not being pulled from there. It's a separate capital.
I believe it's public works fund.
Yeah, public works fund.
It's at this committee because it's Riverbank
staff.
Actually, didn't we request for 2017 that becomes part of our portfolio that's under P&D?
Excellent point from Councillor Edie. That
we
has
in the budget raised, process. You, yeah.
I had meant to point that out. That, yeah, I have raised that in the budget discussions. That good memory, Councillor Edie. That the budget consideration of the PPD riverbank stabilization budget, that's always in the budget, it always takes two pages, that should come to this committee as opposed to Councilor Orlico's planning committee. And that, as my understanding is, the staff are going to make that happen. That was a very good catch last year by Councilor Edie. So we are, after all, the committee with riverbank management in the name, we should be looking at the big riverbank management budget. Okay, so 2.7 million dwarfs our budget for other riverbank stabilization projects. That's great. Okay. So any further questions? If not, Councillor Edie, do you want to make a motion?
That. Yes.
All
absolutely.
Right. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. That is passed. Thank you. And fourthly, as part of our lead up to the climate change committee's report coming in soon, we'll have, I think Ms. Koster is here on item number 4, and that is the update to the community-wide climate change action plan. Not yet the report from Councillor DeBassi's climate change committee. The Councillor Allard, you're on that as well, right? Councillor Allard?
Yes.
Yes, thank you. And Councillor Gilroy.
Gilroy, would I be able to just say a few things about putting this in a bit of context with the climate change group, if you don't mind? Yeah, so basically this is the second of two update reports we've had on the city's climate change work. The first one that came here was a few months back, you'll recall, was on the corporate emissions. This is the work to date on the community-wide emissions, which under the FCM framework we use, under Partners for Climate Protection, you're going to be hearing me saying a lot of these things in the next little while, under that planning framework, that's how municipalities, over 200 municipalities that are part of Partners for Climate Protection, carry out their work, so within that framework. So we've already had the report, it's gone through council for information and was referred, of the corporate emissions, which was referred to the Climate Change Working Group. This is the second one, which is a consultant's report, which is basically the baseline information about our community climate community greenhouse gas emissions. So there's a lot of information. It's a long report. We're going to need some time to go over it. I just saw it a couple days ago. So the recommendation is just that it be received as information and referred to the Climate Change Working Group. We're working on recommendations to come forward before the end of the year, which is quite quick, on the community. And I just wanted to add that on the community wide part of it, as opposed to the corporate part where we've been talking about it more publicly and more people are more aware of the things we're doing there because we've been doing more in terms of having a fleet plan and a buildings plan and different areas where we've been talking about corporate emissions over the years. On the community wide plan, we really are just starting, and this is step one of five, and all it is that baseline. And so our committee is looking at the next steps, which is creating the consultation needed and stuff to create a community-wide climate change plan, which includes emissions by the whole city. And I would also add that the corporate emissions are 1% of the city's emissions, whereas the community emissions are the rest. So that's a big piece, and it includes composting, and it includes transit and active transportation and some of those pieces. So it's very interesting, and it's a big piece to get started on this. It's in our Winnipeg to get started on this. And this is really just a report for information for us to move forward, and you'll be hearing more about the recommendations of what we think we should do as when the climate change group reports before the end of the year is what we're hoping to do. So that's sort of a framework for that.
I have a question just in terms of when we contract out services, are greenhouse gas emissions considered to be community generated or corporate generated?
I think that's in flux, isn't it? That's changing from it. Well, I'll let the experts respond. I think I know the answer.
I believe in our corporate is where that would fall. So it's currently not required in the scope, but it's an optional thing that you can include in scope when you lease.
Option.
Yeah, FCM allows you certain flexibility in whether you report that in the community portfolio or the corporate portfolio. Right. Yeah, so I think in our last corporate report we included a couple contracts, but we weren't able to get information on all of them just yet.
I've got another comment on that too, Councillor Eadie, is that one of the things that we don't currently have is a clear sustainable procurement policy, and that's something that the committee is looking at and the staff has been working on, and we want to see that because it should be part of things like these contracts more decidedly than it has been.
I wouldn't call it optional. If you're contracting with somebody to provide a service, it's corporate. Just to let
traditionally, it hasn't been in, but now it's being moved.
Has it been in our, the way we've been keeping track of it? If something's contracted, has it been included in corporate or community?
It should be included in corporate.
So it has been included in our corporate measures? No, it hasn't.
But not all of the contracted services have been included yet. And just in our latest inventory update, before that, we weren't including them because we didn't have that data.
So now the way you're doing it now, you are including it.
Yeah,
but it wasn't in the past. So
yeah,
things have been changed. You know, we're trying
community
to
doesn't control it, the corporate controls it. So, okay, good.
Good question, yeah. Well, I'd just like to move it forward for information and refer it to our group so we can review it further and include it in our process.
The final report will come back here.
I think the motion had it coming to EPC, didn't it? So
it'll end up in.
Yeah, but I mean.
To the report from.
The report from my group.
Yes,
yeah,
it is coming back.
Yes, the way the motion was worded was it goes to EPC for our report. And it does cover, you know, it should. Ultimately, though, I think this topic is going to come back to this committee, I would imagine, because it is in the environment is in the title of this committee now. So
yeah,
it would make sense. But that particular motion
just like
had...
Riverbank just trying to figure it out.
Yeah, no, it's a good question. So I'm assuming that in the future something, many things will come here about climate change, but it's just this one was set up that way.
Okay. Anything further?
No, I think Councillor Gervasi covered it off.
Okay. Thank you. Okay. We'll have motion from Councillor Gervasi then to...
Just receiving it as information. It does go to council.
Okay.
It goes all the way to council, yeah.
All right. We'll have said motion from Councillor Gervasi. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Thanks.
Audra. And so I think that's it.
Sent an adjournment.
All right. We'll have Councillor Eadie move adjournment.
I move adjournment with concern that we didn't add the addendum that should have been added. Thank you.
Okay. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. And that is carried.
Okay. She's back now. And she's going to be.
Thank you, councillors.
Thank you.
Yeah. Now you have more work.
Yeah, no kidding.
We don't have a big
plan. I know. It's going to be different. I feel like.